Hello everyone, my name is Dycart, and this is my let's try of Master of Orion. I have never played this game before, not even once, and I've never even played the old version from years ago. In fact, I just purchased it, downloaded it from Steam, loaded it up, changed a few of the graphic options. I don't even know if those are going to work right. So, thought I'd record my first experience with the game, so if anyone's interested in seeing what the game is as a total noob, and how easy it is to pick up and things like that, this is the video to watch. So, without further ado, let's jump right in to our single player game and see what's going to happen. So far so good. First menu option worked. Match. You can play multiplayer? That's interesting. Ooh, do I do a tutorial? Nah, forget that. Let's just jump right in. I'm going to be a total noob.
Hailing from the cloudy planet Altair, the proud Alkari are an old race of avian hominids. Although well known for their peaceful disposition, they are fierce in combat and will rarely back out of a fight if they believe they have just cause. The Sky Lord rules over the flock uncontested. He is the de facto commander of all Alkari fleets, crewed by highly skilled and disciplined soldiers. Their pilots are among the finest in the galaxy. Alkari religion permeates every aspect of their culture, and their zeal can oftentimes be confused with fanaticism. They believe The God of Sky created the Alkari to gaze over every horizon, and have...
All right. Whoa, look at this. Look at all these things. Wow. I'm already lost. Are you lost? Well, at least we're lost together. Okay, I'm not going to create a custom race, I don't think. Since I don't know what any of this stuff's really for in the game. I don't even know how this game works. So I just wanted to stop the voiceover. I'll go back, just pick a race, and just kind of just go from there.
Elusive and the heart. Deep.
Just kind of looking through them really
under the supervision
quickly.
Of the controller at Mentor,
like these guys. Look
a sprawling
cool
network
are.
Of Cylon
four
communities
oh my God, I got
comprise
four cool
the
arms.
Quanta.
Ooh, might have to do Cylon just because they look cool.
The blazing savanna alone in their unique
let's do
under
it.
The
like
supervision
technology.
Of the controller
like
at Mentor,
people. He's cool
a
looking.
Sprawling network.
Boom, we're doing it. All right. No idea how tough this game's going to be, so I'll just leave everything at default. Type, size, age. Ooh, I wonder what that changes. Planet density, starting age, difficulty. I'll just leave it on normal. This might last 2 minutes. I might get my butt kicked, lose the game, and be done. So this may be a long video, maybe a short video. Regardless, I'm not planning on making this a full Let's Play. It's just a let's try. So when I get in the game, play it for a little while, and that'll pretty much just be it for the single video. Unless, of course, I get some comments asking me to do a let's play on it. Then, you know, I might spend some more time with the game and do one, or even continue this one. But anyway, oh, I like this Big Bang Seed. A classic game pace. I don't need advanced settings. Let's just start this darn game and see what it's like. Oh, all right. Cool opening cinematic.
From the beginning, the Cylon have looked to the stars above Mentor and wondered. Generation after generation, the isolated Cylon quantums strived to unravel the mysteries surrounding them.
Oh, this looks
so
cool.
To add an iota to their combined knowledge. Now the time has come for the Cylon quanta to go beyond in their search for answers. To travel to the deepest reaches of the galaxy and solve the enigma at its core.
Greetings, Controller. You are the Controller, of course. It follows that I am Moldred, your cooperator. I'll be assisting you with any and all needs for your projects in the galaxy and updating any relevant parameters as we get new information and so on and so forth.
I like his voice. All right, first I recommend clicking the A Fleet Needs Orders button to select your fleet. Hey, that'd be this big thing. All right, I selected my fleet. I don't know that he, I was expecting him to say, okay, now try doing this. Let's see here. Ooh, that's some quick scroll there. Current fleet, colony ship, scout ship, and frigate. What's this? Ooh, look at this. Mentar Prime. So I got population, credits, defense, security. How's that different than defense? Ground defenses, marines. Okay, security. Ooh, discovering enemy spies. Higher the security level makes it more difficult for opponents to achieve missions. Ooh, so there's some spy activity going on here. I like that. That's pretty cool. Man, look at these guys. They're cool looking. Oh, sweet. Little scientists, little farmers, little engineers. Oh, man, this is sweet. Manage structures. Oh, let's see what. Capital, starbase, and marine barracks. Oh, and it shows where it's at on your planet. Dude, this is impressive. Cultural administrative center of your empire. Wow, this is cool. I'm already impressed. I don't even know anything about it. Starbase. Armed orbital platform used to build and service military spacecraft. Alright. Marine barracks. These are going to be my ground troops, right? Ground troops to protect the colony from enemy invasions. Awesome. Oh, what to do now? Maybe I should have started with a tutorial. What do you think? Let's see here. What's my empire? Right now I'm balanced. I can set its focus. That's pretty cool. Let's produce something. Haha. What do we need? Who knows? What do these do? Latest discoveries. Fully automate the production processes in it without need for any workers. It is ideal for worlds with low population as it generates production points. I don't seem to have low population. Trade goods converts 50% production into a billion credits. Wow, billion credits. Yikes. Is that just it's not 1 billion credits. That's just what it's called instead of just credits. It's billion credits. So I wonder if this means I'm getting 12 billion credits per turn or something like that. Missile base. Defense. Scout ship. Colony ship. Okay, and I already know I have one of these. Space factory. What's this do? Wow, this game seems pretty in depth. I may certainly regret just jumping in like this. All right. I don't know if I want any of these right now. All right, out of there. Let's see here. Ooh, leaders. No, I don't have any leaders. I'm dumb. Bunch of lemmings. Man, he is cool looking. Look at that. Oh, so sweet. All right, so I don't have any relations yet, obviously. I haven't met anybody.
Controller, our labs are staffed and ready to start researching. What should we focus on?
Oh, so cool. It's even got some funky music going on. All right. Ooh, research lab. That's pretty cool. Laser cannons. Hydroponic farm. I assume food's going to be important. You know what? I like research. Let's do this one.
Excitement!
He's awesome. Alright. Ooh, pop this welcome. A fleet needs orders button to select your fleet, except for pre-warp. Okay, thanks.
Controller, let me interrupt you for a second.
Left click to move the fleet. Oh. Well, shoot. He went away. Is there an advisor button? No. Fleets, planets, path to victory. Oh, it shows everybody's. Wow. It's just started the game and I'm in first place for score. Alright, I like this. Should I quit now? That means I win, right? Alright, so select your fleet. I thought it said left click to move. Maybe I need. Ooh, yeah. Let's explore that planet. Did I tell it to do? Fleet. There you go. Oh! Ooh, what's on this planet? High gravity. That was low gravity, so I'm assuming low gravity is going to be a better choice for me. A warp point. Oh, I see. So I can warp. Warp to this other system. Let's try it. Woohoo! Okay. Boy, I liked having that little dude pop up and talk to me. But I clicked on the fleet to follow his instructions, and sure enough, everything went bye-bye.
Good science takes time. Genius!
Man, he's cool looking. Boy, I wish I could get that guy to pop up again. Let's take a look at my planet here. Generating research, food production. Yeah, it still wants me to choose production. Maybe I should just build something, huh? So I'm assuming this little icon means time, like how many turns it's gonna take. Well, defense, resource structures. Let's build one. Done.
There's new data you should take into account.
Oh, there we go. Next turn. Okay. Ooh. Hey, first turn done. All right, we're looking good. All right, so that guy. Oh, so it's telling me that he's still moving. Well, there he goes. Desmos discovered. Oh, I see. Cool, let's check it out. Wow, that screen scrolling's crazy fast. Yellow star.
Controller,
oh, pirates.
Let me interrupt you for a second.
Our ships are equipped with a special device capable of estimating an enemy fleet's strength. Is that a scanner? To compare the strength between different fleets, first click your fleet, then mouse over the enemy fleet. Oh. So he's got two pirate raiders. So there's my fleet, and I mouse over. I'm 8 attack, 18 defense, 4 attack, 2 defense. I should be able to beat him, right? It says I should win. Should I try it? I have no idea what I'm doing. There we go. Boom. Boom. All right. Pirate fleet detected. Saw that. I don't know what. Oh, the next area. Okay. Oh, because he must be right near the warp point. Oh, look at that. That's cool. Showing the warp area. All right. So here we are. What do we got here? I can attack. Sleep. No moves left. Let's attack. Victory chance is balanced. Oh. Auto result. Let's auto result. Yeah! Victory is mine! Alright, I only took 5% damage. I don't know what this means. I don't know if this means I picked these up or if it means I gained them, or like I picked them up and gained them, or what? Or maybe I used these, and this is the damage that they did. I don't know, but I won. Take that, pirate scum. Okay, so now that I'm awesome, maybe I should start looking at these planet things. Oh, research complete. Another pirate fleet. Choose research.
Even without me, our scientists have made a new discovery.
Man, this guy's cool. I want to play it just to see this. He looks good too. Man, these graphics are cool. All right, research laboratory. Gives me a research bonus. All right, and then government support. Puts up morale. Wait, all right, done with that. Ooh, economics might be good because now I'm gonna start building buildings that take maintenance. So plus one credit per population if I do that one.
The Economic Research Committee concludes this is what we need to advance.
Imagine that, the Economic Research Committee wants me to research economics. The Economic Research Committee concludes
this is what we need to advance.
Biology for social and scientific, military. I'm gonna do economics.
Eureka!
Eureka! Ooh, view technology tree. Oh, that's cool. I like this, very Civ-like. So I imagine probably in like Civ, I could select something to build the queue up. We'll see, we'll just go one at a time. All right, he's moving, next turn. A viable planet. Colonizing planets from different planetary systems is a good way to expand the range of our scanners. Choose planets with good biomes to boost population growth and high mineral richness to increase production. To establish new colonies, select a fleet with at least one colony ship and select colonize. Okay, thanks. Alright, so that seems like a pretty good planet, evidently. Maximum population 6. Production's only 3. I don't know if that's good or not. Oh, it's a tiny planet. Specials as gems. Gives a 1 billion credits bonus to the colony. Bonuses, 2 credits. I wonder if that's 2 once or if it's 2 every turn. Okay, let's go look at some of these other planets first. No info on this one? What the heck? I could look at this one. Do I need to... Oh, high gravity. This was low gravity. So obviously I need low gravity. This is an ocean biome. Let's go look back over here at our home planet. That's a Terran biome, but low gravity. So maybe low gravity is an important piece of the puzzle. All right, you were supposed to move, buddy. There we go.
Controller, let me interrupt you for a second.
Production complete. To build a structure on any node, send the factory to it and select build from the fleet widget. Keep in mind the ship must remain at the node until the structure is finished or progress will be halted. Okay, thanks. Let's look at our production choices now. Ooh, we got our new research laboratory. Let's do that. Research is always good. Although I almost want to build a colony ship. Let's do this. I am probably completely screwing this up. So bad. I have no idea what I'm doing right now. Okay, skip, sleep, scrap. I thought it said to go somewhere to build. Does that mean I want to, like, what? Can I tell him to go here?
Furthermore, controller, you might want to see this.
Our scanners have detected an anomaly. These strange eddies are usually located off the usual warp points between stars. They may be an SOS beacon of a derelict ship or a particularly dense resource cluster, but are usually worth the time to explore. In order to claim an anomaly, use one of your ships to scout it. The ship will move away from the warp points towards the anomaly and return to its starting point once it's been explored. Ooh, it makes me think I need... I need more like scout ships just on their own. Okay, thanks, buddy. Doing good, advisor. Let's see what my choice is. Gas harvester. Ooh, bonus plus 5 credits. Takes 5 turns. I can't build these. It must be the cost, or maybe I just don't have the requirements. Sure. More credits is always good. Start building that sucker. I'll leave him there. Go down to my fleet. See, this is a low gravity place. Oh, here we go. Oh, wow. That looks what? Max population 12. Swamp biome. That's not ideal, obviously. But low gravity, but no special items. So this is a possible. Let's flag that planet. I assume that means. No, that didn't make it look different. Huh. I don't know what that means. All right. Space factory completed. Yeah, I know that. Where was that anomaly at? Oh, there it is, right there. Can we move one of these scouts out of the fleet? Where's the fleet? There's a fleet thing here somewhere. Fleet! There we go. It's this guy. Fleet A. I was hoping I could, build new fleet or move a guy out of the fleet. Huh. Maybe I can't. Can't drag him. Well, let's use this whole thing really quick then and run over to this spot. Oh, it did separate him. Never mind. You come back. I want you to check out these planets. You go here. Check out that anomaly. Look at this. I've already beat this game. I own it. This game ain't got nothing on me. One of our colony ships has reached a hostile planet. We do not recommend settling a colony here. Uh-oh. Let's take a peek. High gravity, barren. So it must just be the barren, like once it's in the red, that must be considered hostile to us. Interesting. Interesting. All right. Check this one out. Oh, I've already seen that one. So this one seemed like the best one. Do I colonize? You know what? Let's colonize that one. Go! Colonize! Ooh! Oh, look at that! Oh, I got an achievement! Yeah! One small step. Oh, this is cool! Very, very cool. I am liking this game so far, even though I have no idea what I'm doing. There it is. Boom. On my planet. Oh, and I can produce on a planet. So each planet's like a city. Like, it's a, man, look at that. Looks so good. How the atmosphere is rotating at a slightly different rate, it looks like. Man, look at that. Oh, there's a city, I suspect. Whew. Some cool looking stuff. No structures yet, because I haven't built any. Not producing any research, though. Only food. So I need to start thinking about what I'm going to build. So a factory is going to help with production, which is then going to help building more stuff, right? Oh, wait, government support. Oh, that's what I brought up earlier. Missile base, marine barracks. Oh, star base. Maybe that's what I need. Ship self-repair enables Battleship Titan and Doomstar construction. Ooh. Oh, no. Huh. Let's build this factory first. Looking good, guys. Alright, a fleet needs orders. He no longer has a colony ship. He's just a frigate and a scout. You know, I kind of think I need that scout to, Yeah, so all you have to do is select him individually and then move him, and he automatically separated. That's pretty cool. Alright, So I'm going to send him out there to just kind of check stuff out. Ooh, there's some pirates.
Space pirate.
He's only got a turn left on his work. I'm going to send this guy back to the home planet. I'm assuming this means it's got two turns, yeah, until the research laboratory is done. I don't know, ETA's... maybe that means it won't build. I bet that's the problem. I chose a wrong... Yeah, it's in progress, but this, I think that means it's just never going to build. So there's nothing right now that's going to be built. I suspect it's because obviously I'm not producing anything yet. I wonder if I just need to let my population grow a little bit and then they'll start producing. Like once a little guy's born, or can I move this guy? Oh, how cool is that? Look at me, I can drag him around. Oh, sweet. So yeah, I can put on production, but of course he's going to be starving. So I'm assuming it's going to be better to do this and wait until it grows a little bit. Or possibly, maybe I can send my little construction ship over to here to build from outside. We'll see. I'll find out next turn. All right.
The anomaly turns out to be a derelict ship, floating eerily empty with no signs of its former crew. Your engineers report all systems are fully functional. Even if some crew members might refuse to board the ghost ship, it will make a great addition to your current fleet.
Sweet, I got a frigate. Awesome. All right, let's take a quick peek. Blueprints, what's that? Oh, you can edit your ships. What stuff's on them? Oh, that's very cool. But a frigate looks like it's got some pretty decent weapons. Yeah, 8 attack, 10 defense. So that's definitely a fighter ship. I never know because I'm used to old games like Colonizations where a frigate could fight, but I used it mainly for hauling. So to me, it's a cargo ship, but obviously it's not. Let's see. Looks like I can't travel unless it's already popped something up. Can I? Yeah, I can't right click and tell him to go there. So, I might just have to send him down here with the, Oh, maybe I can't send him anywhere. What the heck? Oh no, he's got lines drawn, like he's already going. That guy's going. Alright. Ooh, he finished. Superscalar gas harvester. Awesome. All right, dude. I'm happy with you so far. Let's see if you can build stuff on that planet to help you get started. Uh-oh.
And now,
the news. This.
You are tuned to GNN, the only network that tells you what you need to know. Bringing it to you live.
Galactic News Network, the galaxy's most reputable news source.
Are you going to tell me news?
Controller,
guess not.
You might want to see this.
Ooh, an electromagnetic disturbance nearby. Okay, thanks. Let's see. Research lab done. Good. Research complete. Good. Where's the, the disturbance is there. All right, and I already got a ship coming, so I'm not going to worry
about it. Even without me, our scientists have made a new discovery.
Yeah, bringing in the money. biology. Yeah, that might be worth it. Get me some more food going.
Let's genius!
I know, I'm genius. Alright, ooh, what to build here? It's got good research going. At least, I assume it's good, because it's higher numbers than all the others. Alright. Oh, you can do a queue. I'm not going to worry about that now. Ooh, what's this? Nice. Extra money. Extra money is always good. I do need a colony ship, though, and I wanted to build another one. That's going to take 25 turns. Maybe I should build a factory first. All right. Done. Uh-oh. Pirate fleet. Uh-oh. Pirate raider. Ooh, he's only 2 attack and 1 defense, but my guy has no attack, and he's by himself. So, retreat. Oh, he's chasing me. He is chasing me. Okay, where'd my other guy go? He's coming. All right, I need this guy down there to kick his butt. Where am I at here? All right, I got this guy back. I was planning on building that colony ship and just kind of merging him. Guard. Threatening fleet detected. Well, duh. He's chasing me. Alright, you. You come down here. Right there.
And now, the news.
Are they going to give me some news this time?
The Lacan Hive has discovered the remains of a long-lost Orion facility. Whether this was an advanced research facility or a particularly well-built hotel and casino, it is too early to tell.
Okay. I guess that was important. All right, buddy, you keep running. And can you build here? Oh, you can't. So I bet he can build on these other planets. But I have an enemy coming in. Man, I was really hoping. He could like build a stuff on here to help out. Well, let me test something out here. Let me see if I can actually send him back and see if he can build more on this planet, or if it's just one per planet. At least I'll figure something out. Yay, research complete.
Even without me, our scientists have made a new discovery.
Even without you. Food and research, ooh, I like that. All right, now what do they want? Military guy wants this. Ooh, destroyers. Anti-missile rockets. That might be good since there are a lot of pirates around. But man, I really need to figure out how to get that planet I just colonized to start building stuff. That's food. Some sort of a weapon. Deep space exploration. Civil transport. Civil transports allow the relocation of one population unit between colonies. Ooh, so I could build that and send one of my population from my starting colony to the new one to start doing production. I bet, at least, you know, it would seem that way. Colony base, +1 food, allows the colony ships to deploy this life-sheltering structure when settling a new colony. The colony base helps kickstart the new colony's development, and it's especially important for settling inhospitable planets. Well, that seems important.
Excitement!
That's right, excitement. All right, that's the scout. That's by himself. Come on up here, scout. Oh, okay. Ooh, I'm in battle. Victory chances are good. Space pirate and auto resolve. One of these times I'll have to try manual battle, but I have no idea. All right. I won, and I took no damage. That's always good. I kind of wish I got something for it. Like, something. Or did I, and I just didn't see a report about it. Yeah. Oh, well. This guy's got a scout ship and a frigate. All right, you guys can move down there. Another pirate fleet. It's kind of interesting, though.
There's new data you should take into account.
Every population unit in our colony contributes a small amount of credits to our treasury. You can adjust this amount by selecting a tax rate from Empire Management. Keep in mind, higher taxes have a negative impact on morale. Well, shoot. I don't know enough to adjust my taxes. I don't see a morale. Is morale per planet, I wonder? There's Empire. All right. Population. I assume this is, like, if people are on strike. There's morale. Yeah, it must be per planet, because it's 100 here, 70 here. So maybe I should up the taxes up on this one. How do I do that, though? I don't have any leaders, right? Yeah. Alright, so that's Mentar 2. Oh, no, that's a gas giant. That's ocean. Oh, so known planets, but not the ones I've colonized. Alright, so if I go to this one where they love me, 100% morale. Show Q. How do I up my taxes? I'm sure he said in the little thing, and I just didn't pay attention. Path to victory, fleets, planets, blueprints, leaders, espionage, diplomacy, research, and empire. Seems like it would be under empire. Automated factory. Production. Oh, there it is. Tax rate does right there the whole time. All right, capital Mentor. Oh, so this must be the entire, yeah, population 7. So that's my entire. So when I change this, it's per, or it's my whole empire, not per planet. Right now it's at 3. I'm just gonna leave it because I don't want this morale to go down since it's just starting. All right, structures, probably consumption. How soon is this planet going to go up? Growing, 38 turns. Yikes. Yikes. Okay. So it was great to learn about taxes, but I don't need it. Not yet. So yeah, it's weird how you can only go via these warp points. Very Stellaris-like. There's a lot of similarities to Stellaris in this. But I like it because I feel like that must mean, well, if they have to travel via warp, then I'm protected here unless I see them come through this area. So if I set defenses up here, I could kind of keep, that's the way it seems, keep people from attacking my home. But who knows? You know what, Scout? I'll tell you to explore on your own. I'm hoping that if they come in contact with an enemy, they'll just stop. Alright, victory chance is good. Alright, let's see what this does. Take command. Assisted command. Take control of your forces while an AI admiral takes over unit micromanagement. Full control. Make all decisions. Take all the glory. Command every unit. cinematic. Let the AI Admiral take over the battle. Just sit back and enjoy the show. Now let's see that one first. See what it looks like in a close-up battle. Ooh, it's got to reload. Here it is. Dun dun dun. Battle at Tarkuda. This is very cool. It's all dramatic. All right. Paused cinematic. So I can speed up, slow down. I can change the camera. Oh, like an overview camera up close on me. Pirate Raider. Huh. All right, let's do it. Ooh, here he comes. Oh, that must be me in the distance. It's like a showdown. Here he comes. It's like a Wild West. Draw at high noon. Oh. Oh, oh, yeah, took him out. Well, that was kind of cool. Victory is mine. Oh, 1% damage received. But see right here, it's giving me the stats, battle highlights, but I don't see anything showing that I have gained anything at all. Like, unless I get experience or something.
There's new data you should take into account.
All right, new population. You can manually assign population to the task that best suits your strategy, or you can select a specific area to focus on from the pull-down menu and have it automatically distribute population accordingly. You can reassign population at any time from the colony screen. Why, thank you. Let's view the planet. So I had population growth on my home planet. I like that. I wasn't paying attention. I think it was 2, 2, and 2, so I think they just put him right here for the balanced. That's good enough for me. I don't know enough yet to change that on him. Boy, this is 37 more turns. I've got to figure out how to do this. And it might be just build that little ship that I'm researching and build it and send a population from my home planet to here to give them that boost thing. Mentar Prime has grown. Yes. Good job, Mentar Prime. Okay, alright, so now I know. When I'm building something, it's one per planet. That's what I was curious about. So, let's send this guy down here. See what he can build on all these other planets. Scout and frigate. Alright, let's see. Fleet A. I don't see, and I see that the frigate's slightly damaged. I don't know what these icons do. Let's look at my fleet. Fleet! Alright, location. Well, you don't even say the name of the fleet? That's a frigate by itself. That's at Mentar Prime. So this is the one. Scout Frigate 1. You'd think it would say Fleet A, because that's the name of this guy. Fleet A. Oh, but that still doesn't give me... So it doesn't seem like I get experience. Which is kind of like, well, why bother fighting these guys then? Other than just to stop them from attacking me, maybe? Yeah, I'm surprised. I assumed that you'd get some scrap metal or, you know, materials of some sort, or you would get experience that would kind of power up your ships. But I don't see anything to indicate that that's the case. That's really too bad. All right, so you go check out that planet. It's radiated. Definitely not. Oh, it's got gold, though. Normal gravity. But definitely not a planet we would want to colonize. Hey, a new leader! I don't know how I got him. Rank administrator, so they must get some sort of experience at some point. Plus 10% morale. Leader's appearance change. 20%? I don't know what this is. I don't know what that icon stands for. All right. Sachaba understands the shy nature of the Cylon and integrates comforting designs into his architecture style. The Cylon who live and work in Sachaba's creations find themselves happier and calmer without consciously realizing the effect. He's a designer, level 1. They earn experience when assigned. Well, hire him. All right, now he's unassigned. Dismiss. Assign. All right, so assign him to which place? He gives a morale bonus, so that makes me think I need to assign him to the new place. Let's do it. Select the new place. And he's headed there in 4 turns. So that should increase morale and leader's appearance chance. I don't know. Maybe that means more leaders will... 20% more chance of leaders will appear. Or I don't know if that means he'll have a 20% chance of appearing during a job and helping it or something. Okay, well, maybe this will tell me. Hired leaders can be assigned to colonies or ships. Oh, depending on their role, to boost systems or fleets. Rejected leaders stay around for a while before leaving. Select leaders at the Empire bar to go to the leader's management screen. Huh. So if you don't hire them, they'll stick around just in case you change your mind, evidently. All right. Choose production. There's the biospheres. Wasn't there a... Didn't I do that research to build a... Is that these? Allow colonies to better control the environmental conditions. Research and food. Frigate, scout, missile base. I thought there was a... I thought I had researched. Or maybe I'm still researching it. Hang on, let me look at this.
Good science takes
That's
time.
That's what it is. I'm still researching it. Alright, so what am I going to build? I like the biosphere because it gives me research and food. But I'm afraid of building stuff and having to spend. So I could do this. That gives me... Also, I wonder if there's a limit to... Oh my lord, there's pollution in this game? Yikes. Alright, I'm wondering, is there a limit to how many structures I can have? Manage structures. What's it? Oh, I can spin the planet. Oh, that's badass. Capital. Oh, okay, so this is like production buildings, food type buildings, science buildings, morale buildings. I don't know what those will be, and that must be military. Planet info, small. So what I don't know is there a limit to how many buildings I can build on a single planet? Or can I just keep building as long as I have the production? It seems like I probably keep building, kind of like civilization. Alright, so let's go. Let's not worry about how many buildings we have for now. And let's start out getting us the money, and then we'll use that money to pay for the maintenance on that other building.
Pirates are nearby.
Uh-oh, we've reached a pirate base. These hives of scum serve as hideouts for hostile ships that will attack any fleet they cross paths with without mercy. Wiping them out would be a smart thing to do. You need ships armed with bombs, such as destroyers, to attack ground structures. Select a fleet with at least one destroyer, and then choose combat when orbiting a pirate base to bombard it. Okay, so I don't have destroyers, so that doesn't help me. So, ooh, there it is. It's all red. So since I don't have destroyers, I should just go check some other stuff out. So let's go up here. I know that base is there. I'll have to go check it out at some point. Deep space exploration is only 2 turns away. All right, buddy. What can you build here? Nothing. Why can't you build anything? Incompatible. Requires planetology. Oh, so I need research for one of these. Okay. Good to know. What about this one? Incompatible. What about this one? A new ship design has been discovered. All right, so my research completed. That's a scout ship discovered. Ooh, unexplored. What is that? Oh, some sort of a space debris? Gonna have to find out. All right, and I got that new little ship now.
Even without me, our scientists have made a new discovery.
Man, he's cool. Oh, this game, I'm going to sink a lot of time into this game. Definitely. Now I just got to figure out how to wedge it in between all the other games. Alright. Research per cell. I don't know what cells are. Crest prospecting. Ooh, plus 2 production. But poor or ultra poor? Oh, this is for the destroyer.
Genius!
I need to do that because I found that pirate base. I need to be able to build them.
Information you may find useful.
Civil transports carry population from the colony they are built at to where you need it most. Select a densely populated colony and build a civil transport to help populate one of your more sparse colonies. The civil transport will load one population unit automatically when built. You must have at least 2 population units in a colony to be able to build a civil transport. Okay, thanks. So once my production in that town is done, I'll build a transport. Ooh, what is it? Pirate fleet detected. Oh, they're popping out. Maybe I should have kept him back there and just killed pirates as they came out, just so they don't run around. All right, electromagnetic disturbance. We're gonna check it out in a moment, but dude. Can you build something? Yes. Gas harvester, just more money. I don't know why not. Go for it, buddy. Threatening fleet detected. That's different. He's coming in here, and I don't have anybody to fight him off. There's a frigate right here, right? Frigate, come down here. I need you to fight that guy off. The legends were true. We've found an Antaran ruin. They are said to contain the information to travel to the Antaran pocket dimension. For that, extensive research must be done. Send a space factory and build an asteroid lab to start investigation. Oh, that's what those are. So if I send my space factory ship there, I can build an asteroid lab. That's cool. All right, when he's done, I'll send him down there. Thanks, Mr. Advisor Man. Uh-oh. It looks like it's going
to
be an enemy.
I am the Emperor of the Bulrathi. If you wish to keep your flea-bitten pelt on your back, you'll give my kindred a wide berth.
Okay, I have no problem with that, buddy. You look mean. Look at those scars. Man, the graphics in this game are cool. Cool. Oh, next group. Everybody's coming to visit.
You address the keystone of the crag. You are greeted. Keep your distance, and the silicoid will keep ours.
Okay. No problem, buddy.
So
anybody
you
else?
Two and multiply by... Oh, controller. What was I going to say?
A high morale is key to maintain a happy populace. I never would have guessed. Several actions can cause shifts in morale, from high taxes to enemy presence orbiting a colony. Keep an eye on your colony's morale to avoid having some of the population going on strike. These are specialized structures and projects you can undertake to boost morale. Oh, there are. Okay, that's good to know. All right, what do we got here? We completed that. A new ship design. We got that. I know that. Research was completed. And Farmaz. All right. A new little area. Sweet.
Even without me, our scientists have made a new discovery.
Yeah, we need those destroyers. Ooh, look at this. Okay, more choices. More choices. Speeds up ships. Fast armored MIRV and ECCM weapon modifications for nuclear missiles. All right.
The Center for Sociopolitical Studies suggests this is the way to go.
Although, economic.
The Economic Research Committee concludes this is what we need to advance.
I don't know what research per cell is. I don't know what cells are. Evidently, I should have done the tutorial. Forget it.
The military probing agency would like us to invest in this.
Since I met these guys, I'm thinking military might be a good thing.
Excitement.
Let's do it. Excitement. All right, time to try to build that little colony ship thing. Civil transport. 4 turns, that's not bad. And I can also do the destroyer. Ooh. Maybe I should do the destroyer first. But it's going to take 11 turns now. I'm going to do this first. I'm going to build one of them, which will take one population and move it. Oh, this is exciting. Getting stuff done. Making progress. Alright. Alright, we don't want to mess with those guys. Or piss them off. Oh, I see. So these guys must be based here. And these guys based here, I bet, because of their colors. So you, my friend, are going to come back down here. And boy, I might just leave you here. Maybe, or send you this one. Come back down there for now. Processing turn, come on. Uh-oh, what's happening? Pirates and my frigate. Okay. This time I'm gonna try it manually. Okay. Battle paused. Oh, I said skip and it didn't give me the choice of whether I wanted to do it myself or not. Am I in manual mode? I don't know. I won. I figured I'd get that same pop-up that gave me the choice. But whatever. Killed him. A fleet needs orders. Yes, it does. Send it right there. Tell it to guard. Ooh, something special's happening there. Ooh, new people?
The Sky Lord of the Alkari greets you, Wanderer. I trust you have the wisdom to coexist with us.
Sure. I don't know about wisdom, though. Have you met me? Electromagnetic disturbance detected. That's on his. Superscalar gas harvester. Good. Okay, so I want that guy to go down here. But I might want to combine him with this guy. So he's got kind of an escort. So let's move him down there. What happens? All right. Can we combine? Fleet B. Unguard. And looks like that puts them together. Okay. So let's send them here. So that guy's got a bit of an escort. Pirate fleet detected. Of course. Is it a single again? Yeah. I'm not scared of you. Especially when
Controller, let me interrupt you for a second.
All right. Wisely distributing population within your empire is key to improve overall production. To relocate population, select a fleet with at least one civil transport. Got it. And choose deploy. Okay. No problem. So, production, we want destroyers now. You know what? I kind of want two of these. Let's do it. Alright, so got this little dude. He's got one population on him. We want to send him here.
So you take the two and multiply by... Oh, controller! What was I going to say?
Alright, now that we've contacted other race, we should try to build a relationship. You can contact any race we've met from the diplomacy management. In order to speak with another leader, click the audience button. Diplomacy is a delicate matter, so choose carefully what you ask for and what you give away. How about I ask for nothing and give away nothing for now? How about that? The pirate. Okay. We're okay. We're totally okay. All right. Take command. But don't click anything. Is it going to pop up and give me a choice this time? Give me a choice. I want to see what it's like. Battle paused. Let's turn that off. The Admiral AI. So I assume this is him and that's me. I've got two ships. He's got one ship. Speed maybe? I don't know. This is just the cinematic again to watch it. Watch the cinematic. How do I... Okay. Evidently I'm fighting. Scout ship, you're not doing anything. Oh, didn't kill him right off the bat. Well, shoot, I kind of want to see about taking control of these fights. See what it's like. Evidently, when I first said watch it, it just kind of took that as from now on. Got him. Discovered another system. There's something in here. Gameplay. Tactical combat. Start battles on pause. Yes. Start camera mode. Cinematic. Sure. Pause camera mode. Enable Admiral new UI by default. Show tactical battle setup. Let's do that. That might be that thing that gave me the choice before. All right. Frigate and a scout. Let's send you guys here to check this place out really quick. I'm discovering new systems right and left. Oh, look at that. I'm going to be able to build more there.
This is GNN. Right. What do you got Galactic for me news? News Network.
A new pile of ancient detritus has been uncovered by the Clacon Hive, casting early galactic housekeeping in a very unfavorable light.
Okay. Ooh, Mentar Prime has grown. Yay! And I just built that ship, too, and took people away. Research complete. And they did... Detected electromagnetic disturbances. Yep. All right.
Even without me, our scientists have made a new discovery.
Oh, yay. So maybe when those destroyers are built, I can put that stuff on it. Update your blueprints. Yeah. Okay. So for a destroyer, upgrade all. Done.
Controller! Our labs are staffed and ready to start researching. What should we focus on?
Ooh, electronics. All right, let's try.
Genius.
Go with two advisors. Genius. All right, hey, here we go. I thought it said deploy, not unload. Well, let's try unload. Yeah, that put it to 2 population. Ah, yeah, there we go. Now I got some building, and I'm still at +1 food. So I'm still slowly growing, and I can start building that factory. Good, sweet. I like it. So that was worth it. Another pirate fleet. You know what? Why don't you guys come back here and kill this guy? All right, so build a lab. Ooh, it's going to give me research. Research. I like research.
And now, the news.
Members of the Cylon race were momentarily distracted from the grueling plight of daily survival as new ground is broken for the first ancient ruin investigation facility in the Cylon Quanta.
Dun, dun, dun. All right. Well, cool. I like that. I think I'm going to leave that guy here. That's strange that it broke up the fleet when I did that. Why can't I just tell this guy guard him? Skip. I want to leave him there to kind of protect that guy, especially since I'm quite a ways away. You know, I'll just tell him to guard. Threatening fleet detected. Oh, what happened to the other people I had? Oh, they're right here. Oh no, he's right over my city. A blockade! What does that mean? I don't know what a blockade does. A blockade is imposed. Cannot buy production structures. Strongest hostile fleet will control the blockade until challenged by a fleet of your race or a race allied with you. The blockade will impose a morale penalty and confiscate 50% of the credits earned in the colony per turn. Wow. We'll also deactivate the interplanetary administration and block exports from the colony. The blockade can be broken by your fleet, a fleet allied with you, or planetary defenses. Well, I've got people on the way. Have no fear, 2 civilians.
And now,
oh, look at them all kicked back.
The silicoid crag has grown in strength, spanning even more planets and showing no signs of stopping.
Okay. Where did they get a load of me? Okay, I got 2 planets. There's nothing to look at. All right, go save them. Go save them. Upgrade, not quite. Let's, can you upgrade and then go to battle? I don't need it. Okay. Try this again. Take command. There it is. That's what I wanted. Full control. Let's see what that is. I'm a little nervous. This is really cool. All right. Oh, okay. This must be my, like, battlefield. Is that me? That's my frigate. And there's the pirate. So there, I can do lasers, right? Oh, attack. Threatened area. Ships will try to keep enemies within these ranges. Must be that. Yeah. Okay. Drive throttle. Ships will use this percentage of their full speed. Okay. Ram him. viable. Oh, I see. Hit and run combat. Sniper. Brawler. Turn him into a blitzer. Okay, I don't want to retreat. Attack him. Go. Go. Yep, there he goes. Look at him. He's moving in. And the scout ship's staying back. That's what I want. Once he gets in that range. Oh, he's shooting. You're going down, buddy. Take that, pirate scum. Yeah. There it is. Yay. That was fun. So obviously auto battle would be just as easy for those little tiny things. But yay, I broke the blockade. I'm cool like that. Yeah, investigation will start immediately and progress will be shown. In the meantime, the lab must be protected. If destroyed, all investigation will be lost. Okay. So, oh, I see. So it has to research for a while until it's complete. So I have to guard it until it's complete. All right, not bad. Since he's by himself, I'm wondering if I send him over here to this one. Is that that's a space pirate. But those guys can kind of protect him. All right, let's go up here. I'll leave that guy there to protect that. Was this a frigate? Oh, that's just a scout by itself. So I'm gonna need this guy down here. Scout, no. I wonder if they'd pass each other. Let's find out. So again, it just took the last thing I chose and stuck to it. So attack that guy, go. Good. All right. You are going to go here. All right. I'm liking it so far. The only thing I'm not too super happy about is the movement, the ship movement, like having to tell them where to go every turn and stuff like that.
But even without me, our scientists have made a new discovery.
But there's a good chance I don't know something that would make it a lot easier. That if there's something I could do that would just make it better.
The Center for Sociopolitical Studies suggests this is the way to go.
Start working some more towards our military. But anyway, I've checked it out. It's been over an hour now. It seems pretty cool. It's definitely a game that I'm going to spend some time with. But as far as this Let's Try, I've tried it out. Looks really cool. Looks interesting. If you've never seen this game and you were kind of discovering it with me, I hope I've showed enough of it to let you know whether it's a style of game you may or may not enjoy. I know we didn't get into like diplomacy or anything like that, but I have a feeling that would take a while to get stuff really going. So I think I like it enough. I'm going to go out and kind of read a little bit about it, go back and do some of the tutorials and stuff like that. But that'll be it for this Let's Try video. It was more just for fun, just to kind of check it out. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching. If you liked the video, please click that like button. And if you haven't done so yet, please click the subscribe button to watch more of my Let's Plays and Let's Tries. Take care.